Hi there. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. This is a comprehensive playlist where I run you through every solution for most of HackerRank Python challenges. If you are a returning viewer, welcome. This challenge is a very important one. It gets listed as an easy one in HackerRank, but the eval function, which I will run you through why we use it and where we use it and how we use it, is a very important function for what we do in dynamic programming and dynamic execution of the user input. There are a lot of security concerns around how we use the eval function, which I will also run you through. But I'm also going to put together a comprehensive video on the eval function, and I will leave the link up the top right for you to view. For now, today, let's look at a HackerRank challenge solved for you and explained for you. If you've been around in my channel, you will know that I've got a JupyterLab on the right-hand side of my screen. It helps me teach you how to solve this. And I've got the HackerRank on the left-hand side, which we will go through the task just right now. Let me quickly extend this screen. The eval expression is a very powerful built-in function. So if you don't know what a built-in function is in Python or in any other programming language, it is a function that comes with the installation of the programming language when you install it. So when you install Python, the eval function comes with it. Some other functionalities might not be part of the initial installation and you have to install them later. So that's the meaning of built-in functions in Python. It helps in evaluating an expression. The expression can be a Python statement or a code object. So let me quickly go to the task because I have my own way of explaining what this is and how we use it. You are given an expression in a line. Read that line as a string variable. Remember that we're going to be reading as a string, such as a var, and print the result using eval var. So again, the implementation of this one is very easy, but the implications for us as software engineers, data scientists, data engineers, MLOps, it is very important in how we securely design our program. I don't think anyone is using Python 2, so I will not be talking about Python 2. All I'll be talking about is Python 3 today. There is a constraint that the user input is less than 100 characters, which is fine. But the sample input is print 2 plus 3, and it should equal 5. So let me just minimize this window and extend my JupyterLab. And very easily, when I run you through this, so you may ask, hey, why would we just not say print 2 plus 3 and get 5? And is this the answer for this challenge? Well, no, it's not the answer, because we have been asked to use the eval function. So let me just get rid of that one and I'll show you what the eval function is actually about. So if you put a question mark after the function, you will see that the signature for the eval function is that you need to provide a source. You can provide some globals and locals. That all those details will be discussed in my video on eval function. And the doc string, well, the description of the function is that it evaluates the given source in the context of globals and locals. The source may be a string representing a Python expression or a code object as returned by compile. The globals must be a dictionary and locals can be any mapping, defaulting to the current globals and locals. If only globals is given, locals defaults to this function or method. It was a very long description, but let me show you a very simple example. If I do eval of 2 plus 3 as it is, as a number, I might get an error and it will say, hey, it's a type error. Eval argument number 1 must be a string. So here, you cannot import a number. So if I turn this into a string like that, because that is a string now, and if I run that, you will see that, hey, I'm getting 5 here. Now, you might be questioning then, we know that this does not work in Python as a mathematical operation. Python is like, I will just print the same string for you and I will show you the exact thing without taking it as a calculation. So now what does the eval function really do on this so that I can get 5 out of here? Let me help you with that. So what eval function does here, it takes an expression which must be a string and that string can be any string and it evaluates it and it helps you to run that or compile that code. So if I try this on a different kind of input. What if I said, I want you to evaluate this function for me. I want to find the length of this list. Can you do it for me? So what it does, it will run this function in the backend and it will compile what the answer is. I forgot to close that string there. You will see that it says the length of this list is three, which is correct. We've got three members there. If I add banana right there, you will see that I need to use single quotation there because it will be complicated. And you will see that now the length is four. Now you might ask, what are the globals and locals? Because when I did show you this one, it talked about globals and locals. As an example, I can show you something. So I can say the expression that I am interested is X plus Y. That's the expression I'm interested in. And I can define global vars as being a dictionary of X mapping to number three, if you like, and a local vars object of dictionary of Y mapping to seven. Now, once I have defined those, all I need to do is to make a new variable, call it results, and results is the evaluation of the expression global vars and local vars. So you don't really have to call the global equals global vars. If you just run that and then print the result, you will see that it maps 3 to X and 7 to Y, and the addition will be 10. So hopefully you are getting the hang of how we use eval. I understand that the rationale why we use it might be still a bit unsure. You have to watch my video on the eval function when I put the link up the top right. I will explain all the details why we use eval function as a software engineer. So going back to this solution that we need for HackerRank, because that's the reason for this video, I will try and explain it in very simple terms. So we will be given an input, which will be any input coming from the user, and we will evaluate it. Now, I think with everything that I've defined, it should be pretty easy for you to solve this one. So I will be getting an expression from the user through an input function because I will be receiving it as a string. And I need to just make sure I clean the input that comes from the user. The strip function is to get rid of any space at the end or at the front of the user expression that has been provided. Once I do that, all I will need to do is to eval that expression. So I will write this and I will print what exactly is in the task right here. Run that and you will see that the answer is 5, exactly what the output was. So let me copy that and paste it into HackerRank and see if HackerRank likes this idea. Run that code. It says it was successful for the first sample test case. I will extend this, submit the code, and let's see if all test cases are successful, which they are. If you liked this video, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel because I'm making heaps more for you to learn Python as easy as drinking water, and share this with your friends if you think they will benefit from this. Thank you.